Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Evening folks, Best in Slot here, and it's time for another Planet Zoo update. Yesterday the PZ, very cool name, social media team uploaded a brand new screenshot, and that's what we're mainly going to focus on today. But there is also a Dutch article about the game, newly discovered. So we're going to be taking a look at the scraps of new information we are desperately clinging onto that we got from that as well. I do really expect May to be relatively quiet for the game. I suspect June is going to be a fairly big month for Frontier, but it's nice that we're getting some information, however little. We're kind of just piecing together the game bit by bit. Now, before we get started, I've gone ahead and uploaded every single current screenshot, including the new one we have of Planet Zoo, along with the game trailer, into a public Google Drive folder, which I'm going to be linking down below in the description of every video going forward. So if you've been looking for these images in nice big quality, other than the magazine ones from the other day, which are unfortunately a little bit pixelated, then you should be set with my link. I know, I'm way too nice to you lot. Anyway, let's get started. So as I say, the main thing we're going to focus on is the screenshot. They tweeted that with this message. Let your imagination run wild. I imagine they're very excited. Let your imagination run wild and build the zoo of your dreams, piece by piece in Planet Zoo! Exclamation point. So for those of you who didn't play Planet Coaster, and I didn't play it that much, it basically had a modular building system in which you use walls and decorations and everything to basically make whatever you could come up with. It really was very creative. For those of you who don't like spending time on that, however, it also shipped with a lot of prefabricated buildings, and we actually know that Planet Zoo is likely to let people share those buildings on the workshop regardless. I really think within a couple of days, a couple of weeks, etc., you'll be able to go on the Planet Zoo workshop and download a ton of different buildings to populate your parks with. You're going to be able to make brand new parks constantly. It's going to be very cool. The point is, Planet Zoo is clearly going with the same modular building method, and that's pretty exciting. It means a lot of creative options. Anyways, let's take a look at the screenshot itself in a little bit more detail. Now, this shot is actually the same zoo we've seen before already in the two other shots, which means there's not that much new information to an extent. In the first shot, we can see the same huge, I think probably British style, inverted commas, one of the aesthetics in the game. We can see that British style building, and in the second, if you follow my very professionally drawn lines from the flipped image, you'll see all the same matching features. Now, whilst it would be nice to see a new zoo at some point, what this does at least show us is that this area is fairly gigantic. And that's something we're going to cover again a little bit later on. This is a big zoo at the end of the day, with lots and lots of room to build in, and that's only what we've been shown, so who knows how big they'll actually get. As for details in the screenshot, well, there's some stuff here and there. Towards the left, my very professional CSI kind of thing going on here, towards the left we can see what is probably the ring-tailed lemur exhibit. The climbing frame is very similar to the one they were using in the trailer, and given the small size of the exhibit, it seems unlikely that any larger primates would be cramped in there. It could definitely be another small monkey, but the ring-tailed lemur is the only one we know about so far. It is pretty small, but well, so are lemurs. And the climbing frame itself looks really well detailed, even at this small size. I'm hoping that our primates are going to be able to use these things dynamically, rather than a canned animation where they kind of jump on and jump onto certain points and then get off the same way. I'm hoping it's a little bit more dynamic than that. We also get a glimpse at some alternate pathing options behind the exhibit, as well as a different kind of wall via this really thick, rather rustic looking wood, which I think we've never seen before. Further on to the right, we can see what is probably the train terminal. Not only can you see the tracks moving in from the left, underneath a pedestrian bridge actually, which is oddly exciting to me, but the large glass structure basically screams British train station. Not literally, that'd be terrifying. And British train stations usually look somewhat like this, which I'm sure lots do. Planet Zoo is shipping with a bunch of different decor options based on regions or biomes like Britain, Aquatic and Africa, I believe are the three we know about so far. I'm wondering if our trains and train terminals will always have this rather westernized look, or if even they will come with alternate styles. Could we get a Mad Max Thunderdome style train? Probably not, but some variety would be nice. Up at the top of the image, there's this rather odd looking building. Now, we still don't know how entrances are going to work in Planet Zoo. The assumption is that it's going to be like Planet Coaster, and how that worked was, you had a world entrance gate, which was typically default hidden away in like a weird little cave, and you had a park entrance gate. You could move the former in the scenario editor only, and you could move the latter a lot more freely. So your guests would typically come out of one area, but then enter the park itself through another. It wasn't they walk in and they're in the park. There was a little bit of a gap there, depending on how big you wanted to make it. You could add queues and stuff like that to kind of space your people out. We don't see any of that in the screenshot, or we haven't seen any of that at all. And there's every chance it's to the south and off screen, or even that big building to the south. But this weird little building seems to drop into the earth for me. If you look at the entrance, it really does seem to drop down. It looks darker, maybe it's like a subway entrance or something like that. A subway system to get into the zoo might make a lot of sense as a way to get people in easily without them magically coming through a cave in the earth, which always looked really, really odd to me. Backing this up a little bit is that beyond that little building is nothing, basically. It looks like a road and trees. It looks like a maybe an area you aren't able to build in. What that means the large building to the south is, I'm not sure. And that's kind of where the problem is. There's the huge building in the south, which could definitely function as an entrance. It's worth remembering that you can basically put these entrances in Planet Coaster anywhere, so you could put it inside a huge building if you wanted to. Theoretically, the entrances won't have a sort of a set look. It'll be an entrance point that we then control, but I'm hoping we'll be able to build some more classic looking zoo entrances anyway. That's about it for the screenshot, unfortunately. Not much in the way of tangible new information, but we got a look at a primate climbing frame, we got the train station, and generally a much better look at the non-animal focused decorative area of the game. Hopefully this zoo or a new one begins to populate with animals in the coming days and we'll get a look at some new critters. But for now, let's swap over to the article posted by Dutch website tweakers.net. A tweaker is definitely a name for somebody who uses meth, by the way, but I'm going to assume it means something else in Dutch. I hope it means something else in Dutch. Thanks to MJ Carrier on the subreddit for providing with these translations. Let's get started. So they made some comments about how they're worried about the replayability of the game a la Jurassic World Evolution. Their words, not mine. But they said the story mode is likely to make the game more interesting due to its world-hopping nature. We'll be visiting temperate climates, but also hot ones and cold ones as we hop around the globe. I think the central ethos of this campaign is likely to be conservation-focused, but beyond that, we don't really know much at all yet. But they do go on to say about the maps the following. It is too early to... I was going to do a Dutch accent there. It is too early to say with certainty that the parks in Planet Zoo are larger than those in Jurassic World Evolution. But we got that idea. Jurassic World Evolution did take a little bit of stick for its map size, and probably for good reason if we're totally honest. And I'd feel pretty comfortable saying that Planet Zoo will manage much bigger maps than Evolution does. That's not to say they'll all be the same size, and a campaign with identical sized or laid out maps isn't that much fun. People may hate Isla Peno and Evolution as a sandbox, but as a campaign level, it was an interesting change of pace. Well, it would have been if Tucano wasn't always like already a pain in the ass to build on, but that's not the point. It's also interesting to note that the scale of Evolution, and indeed the scale of Planet Coaster, where you're dealing with large roller coasters, is likely bigger than Planet Zoo. Where zoo exhibits, you can definitely build big ones, but a lot of them are going to be relatively small in size, especially for animals like lemurs, for your spiders, your Brazilian wandering spiders and stuff like that. Not every exhibit is going to be huge, whereas we don't really have those small options in the other two games. So it's going to be interesting, I think, even with maps the same size as Planet Coaster, you'd get a lot more out of them in Planet Zoo, but we'll have to wait and see how that turns out. Next up, they talk about the weather system in the game. They say, certainly if you take into account that... take into account that the game has objects that give partial occlusion, such as trees, animals will still get a little bit of wet under large trees, but much less than in open areas. In addition, puddles will occur in some places where the water cannot drain easily. It is something that you will soon not notice. Not soon notice, I butchered it. Now, we already knew this occlusion system was in the game. A much more in-depth system than I think many of us were expecting. I definitely didn't expect anything like this. How it works is animals are going to react to cold weather by hiding in caves, which you can then warm up if you want with heated pads. And they'll seek shelter in caves and under trees when the weather turns on them in general. Not necessarily the temperature, but if it starts to rain, they'll try to hide under large trees and in caves if they don't like that kind of weather. It seems trees will provide less coverage than a cave would, which makes sense, and I wonder if caves maybe won't be an option early on in the campaign, if this is indeed the case. Anyway, the interesting little bit of this quote is actually the drain easily quote. We've heard nothing about this before, and I suspect we're not about to include elaborate plumbing systems in our park, but could, say, hilly exhibits be better at draining water away and making your animals on the high ground happier? Flat exhibits gather moisture a lot easier as the water sits upon them, and that's not going to be a nice environment for some animals even when the rains have stopped. Will dirt and sand, will the texture determine how much water the ground holds? This could definitely be a misinterpretation by the article or whoever wrote the article, or indeed the translation. If anything, I would say that seems likely. This is probably pushing the boat out a little bit too much, but we're going to keep an eye on it just in case. Finally, the article talks about the retargeting system in the game. Now, this is basically how Frontier repurposes, please don't freak out about the word repurposes, but then tweaks basal animation skeletons to save time, but also to make each animation unique. I really do think we're going to see a lot less repeating of animations compared to the likes of Evolution, and the mention of, say, lion cubs playing together and monkeys checking each other for insects and fleas, blah 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 blah, already goes a long way to maybe giving these animals a little bit more life than we've already had previously. That same little snippet of text also mentions camels, as did another article previously, so I think we can safely say camels are going to be part of the game as well. Now, on a side note, before I bid you all a tearful farewell, the full title track for the game, you know, I Wanna Build a Mountain, all that kind of jazz, is going to be released at some point, as in the full, you know, 3 or so minute track, with the game itself in autumn. That may be the most exciting news of the day, in all honesty. I am pretty excited about that. Anyways, there's not a ton of new news here, gotta hear that, but like oatmeal, or indeed love, it's the little things that sustain you. Of course, if we learn anything new, I'll bring it to you lovely folks straight away, right here on the channel. Hell, I'd have done this video yesterday if I wasn't kind of pulling a Sleeping Beauty kind of act. Don't know why I can't speak English today. Thanks for joining me either way. Hit the like button if you found this video informative and if you're excited for Planet Zoo. And I'll see you all next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.